Racing to the 2024 Kentucky Derby, and this time, let's get an update for Monday, February the 5th, the aftermath of Separation Saturday, which ended up with a few long shots winning, Nysos dominating, but he won't be going to the Kentucky Derby. We'll also take a look at the latest Kentucky Derby news. Locked is out of the big race at Tampa Bay Downs on Saturday, the Sam F. Davis, and we'll take a look at that Fierceness trip on Saturday in the Holy Bull and highlight a couple of other recent winners. Starting off with news out of Florida, Locked, who is scheduled to make his 2024 debut in the Sam F. Davis. He spiked a fever over the weekend. He's supposedly back on the track, but no race has been announced. For Locked, you could possibly hit the Rebel Stakes at Oaklawn Park, maybe the Gotham Stakes in New York, but Locked is now out of the Sam F. Davis and a next race to be determined. Epic Ride, let's take a look at his nice win on Friday at the Leonatus Stakes. Of course, this was rescheduled from the week before. Vote No was a 6-5 favorite. Epic Ride was the 8-5 second favorite. He draws off down the stretch. Epic Ride by Blame. He is now 2 wins and 3 starts. The trainer is John Ennis, and we could see Epic Ride in the John Battaglia up next on the Turfway Park Circuit. A nice win for Epic Ride. Now, Fierceness, I wanted to take a look after his loss, give it a day to digest. Let's take a look at that Holy Bull trip. There was a couple of things going on. First off, let's take a look at the start. He stumbled right out of the gate. Then he was bumped from the 8 horse on the outside, the 6 horse on the inside, and kind of crowded in. Then he got a little bit loose. Then he was kind of bumped again about 40 to 50 feet out of the gate. So that took a little bit of the starch of Fierceness early. Another part of the race that I did not like, I think that was more his own fault. He was a little bit ranked down the backstretch. Now, maybe that was from the bumping. You see him kind of move up. The jockey has to hold him. And I didn't like the fact that it just is a natural aggressiveness off the layoff. He was on that bridle and was a little bit ranked. So Fierceness overall, you know, I think we get from this race, it was his first race since the Breeders' Cup, kind of calls into question a little bit of that speed figure from the Breeders' Cup of 105. He was ranked down the backside. Did he need the race? And is he a need the lead type? So Fierceness, those are some of the questions he's got to answer in his next start. Distance, maybe a little bit of a challenge. That pedigree by City of Light out of a mare that has struggled to get some classic winners. So Fierceness, maybe the Fountain of Youth, maybe they stick with the plan to go to the Florida Derby, but we'll see what's next for the 2-year-old champion. Kentucky Derby leaderboard has been updated. Fierceness still leads the way with 36 points. Track Phantom with 30, he worked out over the weekend. Mystic Dan now with 21, and Hades in the top 4 with 20. Uncle Heavy, he has got 20 points. He is going to point for the Wood Memorial at Aqueduct. Liberal Arts ended up closing for 3rd place in the Southwest. Most likely goes to the Arkansas Derby. And then Timberlake still being pointed at the Rebel Stakes, but a possibility that he goes to the Gotham Stakes if they want that 1 mile distance off the layoff. Just Steele continues to get points for the coach. He could either show up in the Rebel or the Arkansas Derby. I think El Grandio is going to stick to more 1 mile and 7 furlong races. And then, of course, that big race coming up, the Risen Star next week. That is going to have a lot of the contenders. We're going to have Honor Marie. We're going to have possibility of Track Phantom. We're maybe going to see Sierra Leone's debut for 2024 and Hall of Fame as he goes into the stakes ranks. So the leaderboard definitely going to make a change after next week's race in the Risen Star. Another winner to highlight from Saturday at Gulfstream Park. It was on the synthetic. It was ballless out, but I like the way he kicked away clear in the lane. Here he is. He was a big favorite in this race, even money. Trained by Todd Pletcher, one of the few winners at Gulfstream Park on Saturday. Ballas out, got the win. He's by looking at Lucky. He can get some dirt horses. He definitely gets some stayers. And the mayor was a stakes winner at Calder, actually. So the buyer speed figures are out from over the weekend. The stakes races on Super Saturday. Nysos with a 105. Mystic Dan with a 101. Hades' new adjusted buyer speed figure is 90, and Uncle Heavy with an 84. Now, Hades originally on Sunday, they had this as an 85. I do think this was probably pace adjusted. The pace was very slow for the half mile and the six furlongs, so it would have been hard to run any faster. Actually, this 90 to an 85, the 85 is probably accurate versus the speed surface. A 90 is more accurate if you pace adjust. We'll have to follow those speed numbers. I wanted to take a look. I like to look at the post-race analysis on these winners. Here's Hades on the gallop out, slow motion. You know, he's definitely looking fit here. He's definitely got some muscle, definitely in the hindquarters. What I like about this is he doesn't seem too winded after the race. This was his first two-turn attempt. He's now 3 for 3 overall. And Hades by Awesome Slew, who overall has been getting some sprinter milers. But Florida Derby looks like it could be the final prep for the Kentucky Derby for Hades. Key thing to note, all three of his wins have been at Gulfstream. If he goes to the Florida Derby, he'll go into the Florida Derby with all four of his career races at Gulfstream Park. But here he is looking in. Looks like a nice horse. Didn't look too winded going into the winner's circle. Overall, a solid effort. He does run with his head high and kind of did get an easy trip, saving ground the entire race in that Holy Bull. So that's a look at Hades post-race as we start to line up the next stake schedule. We've got the Sam F. Davis this coming Saturday. We'll have a preview up on Wednesday. Change of command, going to be going to that race. Back-to-back wins. Patriot Spirit, a win at Tampa Bay. Tireless, a maiden winner at Tampa Bay in his last start. Cardinal, another one for Todd Pletcher. Crazy Mason, a local Tampa Bay winner. And then Elysian Meadows, also nominated for the Sam F. Davis. The Suncoast goes on Saturday as well for the Phillies. Who could ask for Moe? Could be the headliner there. And then also for the Risen Star. Hall of Fame going into the stakes ranks. Track Phantom with 3 straight wins. Sierra Leone for Chad Brown. Honor Marie coming off the layoff. Sneed, second to Track Phantom in the Gunrunner. He is pointing for that. Moonlight for Todd Pletcher. Catching Freedom, Resilience, and Real Men Violin for Ken McPeak. Of course, Ken McPeak with the 2 stakes winners on Saturday at Oaklawn Park, Mystic Dan and Band of Gold. So the Risen Star shaping up to be the deepest prep of the Derby season so far as we start to get to the bigger points races. The Rebel Stakes, Muth and Timberlake. Also the possibility of Coach Prime in that race. He scratched out of Saturday's race against Nisos. And that looks like a good move with Nisos dominating. The road to the 150th running of the Kentucky Derby continues. We've got the Suncoast, the Sam F. Davis, the Las Virginias for Phillies. Then we go to the Risen Star and the Sunland Derby on the 18th. The Rebel Stakes on February 24th. What did you think of Fierceness's trip? Also that Risen Star, any early thoughts? And Locked, where should he go after scratching out? The Triple Crown Prospectus is out. My ranking started this week. Rank number 1 is Track Phantom. You can get all those rankings every week. Sign up free in the description below. We rank the top 12 every week. And the Saturday Notebook, the next one coming out for Risen Star Stakes Day. 25, 26 times this year. We'll post some stakes races, previews, and picks and selections for the Racing Notebook. Sign up below in the description below. What did you think of Fierceness and other comments? Remember, Dwayne Lucas says people have opinions, horses have the facts.